Hi, my name is Lucy, and today I'm gonna give you criteria to choose your school because we're in a global pandemic and there's a lot of college tours that are canceled and there are people like having the TikTok algorithm like choose their school. So like I just wanted to jump in here and give you some criteria. And yeah, I feel like I went through a whole blown like existential crisis like choosing my school. I was mainly choosing between UC Berkeley, USC, and Vanderbilt, and those are three like amazing schools. Like never, like when junior me like even like imagine like choosing between those schools. And like I don't know, like the thing is like I don't really like to like talk about it because I just feel like kind of weird, like, but I don't know, it's to separate me from like Super Tutor TV, like love her, like shout out to like Super Tutor TV, like y'all probably comment and like know her, like love her. But I just wanted to think of my own experience and like my friend's experience because like I know it is like such a like push-pull situation. Yeah, it's a really exciting time and I feel like everybody should take a moment to be super grateful because not everybody gets to make a decision like this. But also I just want to give criteria because like you busted your ass for like 4 years to like get to this position and it's super duper exciting, but also it can feel kind of daunting to like make this decision and there's a lot of like existential crises like going on. So before I like jump into everything, first I want to give the advice that you should be writing like all these like criteria down. Like don't take notes by chance, but like I don't know, like have these in the back of your mind and like make a pro and con chart. And also congrats to all my admits to Berkeley because we heart you. So let's get into it. So the first thing I'm going to suggest, especially in like the kind of situation that we're in right now, is to definitely watch student vlogs. And you're probably like, you're just gonna plug yourself, and like I will, but like I really do think that watching the vlogs will give you like a good look into like what it's like actually being a student there versus like a visitor like coming on campus. Does that make any sense? Because I know that you're probably gonna watch like a lot of like campus tours and like virtual campus like walk arounds, but I feel like whenever you're watching these vlogs, you're watching like the academic scene go down, the social scene go down, and also just the residential halls and stuff like that, to truthfully feel like you're a student there versus like an outsider visiting. And like going off of that, I feel like a lot of these like YouTubers and stuff like that, you can gladly like reach out to them and have like kind of like a big sister, big brother like figure like walking into the school and like answer any questions that you have about the school, including me. If you have any questions about Berkeley, let me know. And that's like the number one thing that I want to get off the bat, because like I feel like that's what makes past years versus this year a little bit different, is that you don't get that in-person experience. And I feel like the best way to like truthfully ingrain yourself in like a school's like campus right now is like vlogs and like talking to students that go there. The next thing I want to talk about is probably the most important, and it's finance. So I think that comparing like your merit scholarships versus your financial aid versus like basically what is like worth it to you or your family or the people supporting you, like what is the most smart decision, like will you have to take out loans, there's a lot of things to consider. And I definitely think that having a sit down conversation with people who are supporting you, or if you're supporting yourself, just like consider like the best option financially. So yeah. Okay, so the next thing I'm gonna talk about is your major. And honestly, I want to preface this with saying that you might switch majors, and I think that it's important to look at if you can switch or if you're like stuck in your major, if it's like hard to move between colleges. Like I know at Berkeley, like it's really, really hard to move from like letters and science to like College of Engineering. So yeah, if you like applied as like a major and you're like, oh, I'm gonna switch, and then you realize like, oh, like I can't switch, then maybe look into that. And I also think that like flexibility is pretty prevalent in like most schools, but do like beware that like some College of Engineering's are hard to like switch into, some like letters and sciences or like biology schools like might be a hard switch into, and like do a little research on like that like flexibility. And next I want to talk about rankings, because I feel like whenever I was doing research, it's hard to ignore the rankings. Like I'm just not gonna, you know what I mean, like front and be like I didn't look at like rankings. I think it's important to look at rankings because like obviously like industry recognition is a super helpful aspect whenever applying to jobs, but I also think it's important to look at their curriculum and like see if anything's interesting. So like I know at USC they have a really cool like CS games concentration. Certain concentrations might interest you more, and if like one school has a concentration that you want and another school doesn't, then maybe consider that. Also, I think it's worth researching into like grad school, law school, med school, like what you, if you plan to go to grad school, like how does your undergrad like impact your admissions process, etc. So next thing I'm gonna talk about is location. Hey Google, play Location by Khalid. But I do think it is like worth touching on, because do you want to be close to home? Do you want to be far from home? Do you want to be in a city? Do you want to be in like a suburb? Do you want to be in like, I don't know, like a very isolated place? I feel like those are things you have to consider, and also like weather. So I want to throw in like my own experience in here. Whenever I see my friends at Cornell posting like, I love this like beautiful snow, like yay snow, I'm literally like, Can't relate. I just know that I don't get along well with the cold. I think that is worth like considering like your mental health and like your mood like based on the weather. I know that it gets like really, really deep, but like actually though, this place is like where you're gonna be living. I think that if you were like, oh, like maybe I'll go to like a school in like Chicago, consider that aspect of it, even though it doesn't seem like very strong. Your mental health is very, very important. I also think it's cool if you can find a college where the surroundings like excite you. I know like my best friend goes to Emory in Atlanta and she's like really excited to like try the Korean food there. And like, I know for me, like I was really excited to be in the Bay Area because like there's so many like really cool tech companies.
I gave a really nerdy answer about why I like the Bay Area because there's like a bunch of like cool tech companies. And like, I just want to say there's a lot more than just cool tech companies. I really enjoy like the culture here. There's a lot of really cool things to do here and there's a lot of really good places to eat. I can't lie. So I was very excited to come here, to say the least.
And I know like my friends at Auburn University like really, really liked like just like, I don't know, the whole like Southern school like vibe from like the surrounding areas. Also, kind of more like logistical tip, but take into account like how much you'll be spending at like a city. Like I know that like food in LA is like more expensive than like food in like Tallahassee, Florida. So like, you know what I mean? Consider stuff like that. The next thing I want to talk about, the culture and like size that you've always wanted for your school. I know a lot of people love smaller classes and like I know a lot of people who can't like thrive in like lecturing environments, and I think that's super, super important to like take into account. Also, I want to touch on like football spirit and just like school spirit in general. I think that every school has like school spirit. I know that a lot of people like would only go to like college with like football teams, and like if that's super, super important to you and you've always wanted to go to game days, you know what I mean? Don't give that up. It's like stuff like that where you only get like once in a lifetime opportunity to like experience like stuff like that if you've always wanted to. Like for me, that wasn't super important, but I know for a lot of people, like a lot of my friends who went to like Florida State University or like University of Florida, like that was super, super important to them. But yeah, like I think that if you do go to like a smaller like private school, like you have to like take into consideration that like kind of spirit if you've always like wanted it. The next thing I want to talk about is culture. Okay, the thing that I have with like culture and like whatever is like everything is super, super stereotyped, and I don't think that it's always like true. Like I know a huge stereotype at Berkeley is that we're like cutthroat and like people like steal each other's laptops and like hack Google Docs and like delete everything, like notes and stuff like that, which doesn't really happen. I think that it's important to realize that at every school, like you're gonna have those people who are like, you know what I mean, like will like low-key stab you in the back, but also I think it's important to realize that you will find people who are nice and like you'll find a supportive network. I think that stereotypes can hold true to some extent.
Hi, I want to say that at Berkeley there is like kind of a competitive cloud, and like at other schools there might be more of like a collaborative cloud. I feel like do your own research, but keep what I'm about to say in mind.
But I think that at every school, like you'll find a really good group of like people that aren't out to get you for sure. So okay, so the next thing I'm gonna talk about is like programs. And if you've always wanted to study abroad, if you always wanted to be in a sorority or fraternity, if you always wanted to be in like a certain club and your college doesn't have that, take that into consideration. I know that some colleges don't have Greek life, and like a lot of people literally come out of the womb and they're like, I want to join a sorority. And hey, if your school doesn't have a sorority, then like, you know what I mean, consider stuff like that and decision like solely based off of that. But if you've always wanted to, you know what I mean, experience like Rush, or if you've always wanted an experience in a certain club that fits your interests like to a T, consider that. I really do think that clubs and like the people that you meet in organizations like can make or break like your college experience. The next thing I'm gonna talk about is resources, like academic resources, tutoring, etc. Look up your school's like tutoring systems and if they have help in general for your major or like your classes. I know at Berkeley, like whenever I knew that like computer science
was challenging,
like I was kind of worried about like the resources, but I found that there's a lot of different things that they do to help, like tutoring, like group session tutoring and stuff of that nature. So I found that like a really good drawing factor because there was so many resources to help me. And I know that in our like residential halls there's like tutoring like groups and stuff like that. So yeah, take that into consideration because finding the support for your college classes is super duper nice. The next thing I'm gonna talk about is alumni connections. And I'm just gonna preface this with saying that like at any college, like if you LinkedIn message like someone from your college, like they'll probably respond, hopefully. But I do know that at like private colleges they do have like a like tighter network. Like I know like whenever I went to like my Dartmouth interview, I didn't get in, okay, like but I remember whenever I went, she was like, oh, like if you see someone with like a Dartmouth sweatshirt at like Starbucks, like you'll like have like a full-blown conversation with them. And like, I don't know, like whenever I see people add like Berkeley merch, like I'm kind of like, oh hey, blah blah blah, but like I don't know.
Hey, how y'all doing?
I think that at every college, like, there's really amazing alumni, and like, you'll definitely be able to connect with them on that like level that like you guys like did go to the same school. But I do think that it is worth mentioning that some schools do have tighter like alumni connections than others. I think that it does make more sense because like smaller schools like have a tighter like more people like know each other, I guess. But like at like a big public school like Berkeley, it's kind of like hard, I guess. But I think that at every school, like, you'll find that alumni are more than helpful. Okay, so the next thing to talk about is food and housing. And first, the one thing I will say is like, you do need to find out if your dining hall accommodates to your dietary restrictions, if you have those. And when it comes to like housing, I think that it's important to look at pricing and also like if it's guaranteed all 4 years. But I do want to mention that like isn't everything. Like, I remember I went to USC and they had like these like face scanners like for you to get into like the honors college. It was like insane. Like, the dorms are so nice, and like the Berkeley dorms like aren't as nice, but I think that in any like housing situation, you'll hopefully accommodate to like having a roommate or like two roommates or maybe three. Like, I know like some suites have like four people. I think that take into account like housing, but don't let that be like the reason that you decide to go to school, if that makes any sense. The next thing to talk about is party scene. Please don't pick a college based on their like party scene. I will say that every college has a party scene. Like, MIT people go hard. Okay, like, I have some friends at MIT and they be going hard, and you wouldn't think that, but they do. And yeah, I think that it's worth mentioning that every school will have parties, so like, don't base it off of that. But I do think it's worth mentioning like how much that's integrated with like, I don't know, like student life. Like, at some schools, like, it is like a super big part of like their social scene, and it's a really great way to like meet people. I know a lot of people like meet people through partying, so it's worth like doing a little bit of research on that and like safety of parties. So take that into account. So the next thing I'm gonna mention, all my criteria are done. I hope you enjoyed them, but sometimes you like kind of don't know where like your heart is, and like, it's hard to like describe, but like, it's just weird. Like, I feel like you just like have so many perceptions of like these schools. Like,
hi, I want to talk a little bit about perceptions and how that impacted my decision. So I was mainly in between USC and Berkeley in the end of like my decision process, because whenever I visited Vanderbilt, like, I feel like something just didn't click for me, and like, that's okay. Like, I literally texted one of my best friends and I was like, this is your school, and now she goes there. So yeah, whenever I was in between like USC and Berkeley, I was like kind of perceiving USC to be like my ticket into like the entertainment industry, and like Berkeley to be like my ticket into like the tech industry. And like, I just like want to say that that is like not a good way to like look at schools. I just like want to mention that every college experience is like what you make it, right? So like, at Berkeley, I feel like the stereotype is like, oh, you're, it's like, it's really hard, and like, everybody's CS, and it's like very, very like cutthroat. Like, you're just like gonna go work at Google and like be a software engineer. Like, I feel like that was like the stereotype that I was like perceiving onto Berkeley. And then like, whenever I got to Berkeley, I realized that there's a lot of people interested in the entertainment industry, and like, it's not an end all be all. And I still don't know if I'm gonna go into the entertainment industry, and hey, I might just be like a tech nerd who like codes for Google. But I also want to mention that at USC, like, yes, they have a lot of amazing entertainment connections, but I also want to mention that they have like a lot of great like tech industry like connections. So I think it's like good to like perceive schools for like their strengths and like what they're kind of known for, but also realize that you curate your own experience in college, and that your school's strengths aren't your strengths, and that school's like perception in your mind might be a little bit jaded just because of like how much information is out there on the internet about each school. I just want to emphasize that you do make your own experience, and I hope that this is like an impactful little message, because I wish I heard this so many times, because I feel like that was why I went to like a full-blown existential crisis, because I thought that my school strengths were like my end-all be-all, and like, that's just not the truth. You curate your own experience, and your perceptions will rarely entirely hold true. So yeah,
but yeah, I feel like there's a lot of like perceptions and stuff like that, and sometimes you just gotta find out where your heart is. So I remember I did this exercise with my friend Kaylee, and she was in between University of Florida and Cornell University, and I looked at Cornell. I was like, this heads like Cornell, like UF is like tails, and she was like, okay. And then I flipped it, and I didn't tell her like what it landed on, but I was just like, when it was in the air for like that 2 seconds, like, what did you want it to land on? So that might be a fun practice. I don't know how applicable that is to everybody, but I did that. I don't know, I just wanted to mention that. And also, I just want to talk about like talking to people like closest to you and like your family and like their perceptions, because in the end, like, it is like your decision. But yeah, I think that you shouldn't be asking like everybody in your contact book because like it is like such a personal decision. But definitely like I know like my best friend, I asked a lot like what she thought about like where I should go, and like I remember I asked like my friend who I always like did computer science with like where should I go? Stuff like that. People who have insight on like you. I just like thought about like the Netflix show, I don't know why. I would say like ask those people, but in the end, like it is like your decision, and like definitely like go into every conversation where you're asking people about your decision, like with that in mind, that it is what you worked for and like what you get to take your life path on. Like it's not their life, it's yours. So yeah. I just wanted to end this video with saying on May 1st, you're gonna end up where you belong. And sometimes it might not feel like that. Sometimes it might feel like, what the hell? Like, oh my gosh, maybe I made the wrong decision. Maybe I made the right decision. But in the end, I can tell you, you will have picked the right school that fits you, that you belong at. And I think that everybody has that feeling whenever they're at their college, hopefully. And yeah, this isn't an end all be all. If anything, it's a hey. This is a really cool door to like enter and continue your life with. So take a deep breath, listen to yourself. I hope that these criteria like helped you. So if you want to know more about like Berkeley school life, like watch my vlog. I made a big in my life. Please message me if you have any questions about Berkeley, about choosing your college, about USC or Vanderbilt, or like I was in between Emory and like UF too. So if you have any questions about that, like I have friends that go there. Yeah, I just want to be helpful, like a helpful tool, because I just wish I had guidance like at the time, because it was just so, it was a good time, but it was also just like a very like crisis time for me. So yeah, I want to be helpful. Please let me be helpful, and I hope you enjoyed this video, and yeah, bye. Picture perfect, you don't need no filter. Go just make them drop dead.